In this tutorial, we're going to be actually programming the transmission. If you're having trouble viewing this, check at the bottom right of your screen, select Settings, and increase your quality. First, you'll want to go to acdelcotds.com/subscriptions. If you already have an account, you can log in. If you don't, click on Don't Have an Account, Sign Up. Fill out the required information, making specific note here on your login name has to be 8 to 50 characters with no spaces. Your password is very strict, has to be 15 to 20 characters long. One uppercase letter, one lowercase letter, one number, and one symbol of this kind. Once you've filled out the required information, write down your password and username. It will send you an email, and you will have to confirm it. To get past this here, you do have to scroll down to the very end and agree on the terms, and then enter in your special password. Enter your email verification requirement code that you received through your email. After successful registration, you should get You have been successfully registered. Please log in with your credentials. Simply click on the login again and use your credentials to log in. Once you log in, you'll have to again agree to the terms. Next, you'll want to select the subscription that fits you. Most likely, you'll want the one vehicle for $40. There are other subscriptions available, but that is the most economical one if you're just doing one every once in a while. Add to cart. Checkout. Make sure it's 24 months access, $40. Again, agree to the terms. Enter your credit card information and place your order. Once you place your order, it will take you back to the subscription page. You have one available, which means nothing has been used on it. Once it's active, you should see a VIN here. Notice at the bottom of the page, it's blocking a pop-up. Make sure your options for the site always allow pop-ups. And it may take you back to the beginning, but once you allow them, you go back in and it'll allow you to continue. This is just stating that we're going to be using Java and allow it to enable future plugins. You want to read over the news and see if it's pertinent to your programming, and then click OK. This is just stating that Windows 10 is now supported. It did not used to be. This is stating about Windows 7. It's no longer supported. What that means is if you call GM, they're not going to help you. It has to be a Windows 8 or better. It doesn't mean it won't work. It just means that they won't help you if you have an issue. GM is constantly updating their software. So as I'm creating this, they could be changing it. It's constantly revolving. So if the screen looks different, it should still work. The basis of the programming is still the same. So SPS is actually where you want to go. And this is when Java starts working. If you click on this and you get no results, check your Java and make sure you have the latest Java installed. When you get this pop-up, run. Your computer may take longer to download information, and you may get a pop-up that says, do you want to allow this app to make changes to your device? Say yes. I'm pausing the video just to make the video shorter. So if it takes a little bit longer, be patient. Click OK. Next, install, and done. This puts you back at the beginning, and it is kind of confusing. A lot of times you'll get a flashing icon down here, or sometimes you just simply have to minimize or maximize your screen and see that there's an icon behind there. Once you get this out in front, or you can just simply click on the Java link here, you want to skip this. Now it's going to download Native Libraries Archive. If your tool is not shown here, I'm using the Kardec M, but if your tool is not shown here, you must go back to Drew Technologies' website and download their drivers. You want to replace and program ECU, and then click Next. The next step is make sure ignition is off. If you have a battery maintainer, use it at this time, or you can use a jump box just to give your battery a little extra voltage. Your voltage has to be maintained during charging, or it could fail and also brick your ECM, TCM. Turn ignition on, engine off. Connect your device to the vehicle, give it some time to boot up, and then connect it to the PC. Then click Next. Select your vehicle make and model. This particular vehicle is a 2010 Traverse. Select light truck, MPV or incomplete for a truck, or if it's a passenger car, select passenger car. Verify your VIN is correct. This one here, you may get different screens. This one here will be a sequential. It will do both the ECM and the TCM. Some of them will be only a TCM. And then the newer ones, 2016 or so, you'll have to make sure that you select an RPO code that is correct for the vehicle. RPO code placards are available on the vehicle sticker and different locations. The two different RPO codes that we'll be requesting is one for the 8-speed transmission or the 6-speed. This is for the 6-speed transmission. If during programming it asks you for a TUN number, you've selected an 8-speed transmission and need to backtrack back to the screen and select the other RPO code. The RPO code for a 6L80, 6L90 is MYC. The RPO code for the 8-speed is M5U. And normally it will ask you for accept M5U. So you want to select anything but M5U and continue on with the 6-speed transmission. Here it may ask you for normal or VCI. Always pick normal. Click Next. You may not get this screen for the engine control module. It depends on if it allows you to program the TCM independently or not. This particular one is sequential. Here it shows the current calibration, which is already checked off in green, and it gives you a brief description down here if you want to change the calibration. I'm going to change the calibration so it has something to program, otherwise it'll tell me that it's already programmed. Click over to the transmission. That is what we're actually programming. This one only has one calibration available, and it's already there. So it won't be programming the TCM, but it will be programming the ECU. It goes through the same steps. Click Next. This is a confirmation screen, just telling exactly what you're doing. Click Next. Now it's downloading all the information on the network, and then uploading it onto the ECU or the TCM. Again, the TCM has the same screen, it just will say TCM instead of ECU here. After both bars are across the screen, you'll get an information saying that the ECM passed, it did program, and it skipped the TCM. And we knew this because we were only programming the ECM. It would say pass TCM if the TCM was also successful in programming. Here you can go ahead and clear the DTCs. You won't get confirmation once the little blue swirly clock is done swirling. The programming is complete and the DTCs are cleared.